Hello everyone, this is Direwolf20, and welcome to episode 39 of Direwolf20's server play series on Forgecraft. It is raining and such. I guess that's not a big deal. Well, it might be a big deal. What I'm going to do today is primarily focus on getting to the end. I would like to get there because, let's bring up our CAD instructions here. There's a few things we haven't checked out yet with... Oh man, we got memory management? Nice. That is cool. That's something that's going to be really neat and very cool. Secondary operators, huh? Nice. All kinds of cool stuff to look at with this. But one of the things we want to look at is greater infusion. Gives you the ability to make psi gems. Further, ebony and ivory will infuse coal into an ebony substance and nether quartz into an ivory substance, both of which can be combined with side metal to create the respective alloy. These alloys can later be used to create really good stuff, but they can only be used while in the end. So what I'm going to do is bring a matter receiver with me to the end. I want to double check. I'm pretty sure that if I hook this dude up to some power, he'll be able to retain it while I go running around. So let's do that. Power, please. Thank you. There we go. Cool. And he should be, yes, energy stored. Cool. I'm not going to put power out there because it's just like my quarry in the dimension that I set up. I want it to be, basically, I'll take the durability or the little dizziness effect. So where's the end? Oh, there it goes. Okay, cool. So off in this direction, looking for an end portal. Okay. So, still off in that direction. Cool. You know what I should really do before I go to the end? I should really consider flight. Part of me wants to get intangible flight, and another part of me remembers that I've already got a ring. Nice. So right now, if I'm not counting, so I've got a grid power of 49, but that's because it's daytime, right? They have got a grid power of 20 at night, because we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, so that's 26, right, power? I should probably boost that up a little bit, but, well, I should be okay. Let's make sure it's daytime in the overworld. Maybe I'll move my solars as well. To make sure that they're over here. I could probably move this whole setup, to be honest with you. Oh, I've got even more solars in here. Nice. I'm gonna put these on top of my base. Cool. So that's 27 solars. That basically means I can almost fly during the day just from solar power. Yeah, see, no more flight now because... Yep, definitely no more flight. Let's pop these up here. Cool. And I can put another set. I'll start it over here. And that should be good enough for now. So let's see if we can find ourselves a portal to the end. I'm just going to go off in this direction. Okay. And then what I'll do is set up my matter receiver in the end, assuming, of course, that I've got enough ender pearls to fill out the end portal. And then we'll take it from there. I want to say that's McJady's base. Still in this direction. How about I get a little bit of progress, and then we'll come back. Oh, I think we've got progress. All right, let's do... Oh, I got an idea. Break 7 below. Remember, I've still got flight, so, you know. All right, so that was not quite as good as I had hoped it would be. I would expect that to have gotten a little bit better off, but let's see. Yes. Right, exactly. So let's do break square. It's up from here? Okay. I feel like this thing's lying to me. Alright, guess I will find this. Let's come back in a second once I've made some progress. Alright, I'm off hunting for another end portal, and it looks like somebody has been being very bad with Thawncraft. Away! Yeah, the end portal that I found a minute ago wasn't anything. Like, the pearl just bugged out, I guess. I've seen that happen once or twice. I don't know what's up with that, but it's definitely happened. Aw, that one broke. Alright, continuing to search. Alright, looks like I found a spot. Ooh, looks like I'm not the only one to have found a spot. Or maybe I am. Don't tell me this is another false positive, because that would make me very upset. I feel like I'm not the first person to come here and become upset about the false positives. Yep, definitely a false positive again. Not cool. I'm gonna need more Eyes of Ender, which means I think I'm gonna need more Ender Pearls, because I used them all. So, Enderman Spawner, let's get to work. So, I've finally found a stronghold. Third time's the charm, I guess. I'm guessing someone else has been here, because a lot of traps have been set off and there's torches all over the place. I wish there was a map that led to the end, but I guess we'll just have to find it ourselves. I'm guessing somebody might have put a matter receiver in the end already, by the way. I'm just kind of trying to make sure that I find my way to the end myself, not use somebody else's matter receiver already. So those of you who might be saying something like, Dire, you should check to see if the matter transmitter is already running. No, I'm not going to. Well, I might do that. We'll see. If I can't find the entrance to the end portal anytime soon, I might do that. Depends how frustrated I get looking for the end portal. And the eye is not helping, because it's stopping at a point that is not an end portal. So we'll look around for a little bit, and if we don't find it, then I will try matter receiver to the end. We'll see. For now, I'm going to continue looking if I can. And we'll be back in a minute. I found it! End portal achievement get. Nice. Alright, so I've got my matter receiver. I've got my advanced charged porter. Let's just be safe, set a waypoint. So we're going to call this end portal. I don't know if the dragon's in there or not. We're going to find out right now. So I'm not seeing a dragon, which is cool. I'm okay with that. Oh, wait. Nope, they're just windmills. I thought that was a dragon for a minute. I don't know who set up windmills in the end. Oh, I see. It's powering. Okay, matter receiver. Cool. The end. Nice. Okay, so somebody did set this up, which is cool. I mean, now that I found my way there myself, I don't have to use my own matter receiver, which is good. So I should be able to dial that up relatively easily. We should just see the end. So there's Dire's base, end hub, or the end? The end is what I want to dial. So Dire's transmitter to the end. Dial it. Boom. Nice. All right. What did I want to do out there? I wanted to bring some stuff. Let me sort all that and blink our way up there. So we're going to want two spells, right? Greater Infusion, Trick Ebony, and Ivory. Okay. So let's get a couple spell drives or spell thingies. So we can change Sleep. We don't need that one anymore. And we can get rid of Jump. We probably don't need those. Can I clear these in some way? I forget. I can just overwrite what's in them. So I think all we need is Ivory. Ah, it's one trick. Okay, cool. That's neat. And it doesn't have any inputs or outputs. So, boom. Trick, Ivory, and Ebony. Neat. Ivory, Ebony. Excellent. Cool. And the items for that were Nether Quartz and Coal. Cool. So should we get like a stack of each? Does that sound cool? I think that can be arranged. And then this drive, which is the sleep function. This was just when I was leveling up sleep. Can go away. So let's zip on back to the end. Whoosh. So it should be as easy as just dropping this stuff on the ground. Hooray! Ebony substance. Nice. Alright. And then nether quartz. How much psi energy do I have, by the way? 42? 5,000 is the limit. Cool. Ivory substance. Nice. And back away we go. Hooray. That is the greatest. Should charge my charged porter real quick. By the way, I do currently have my lever in a state that is off, just FYI. So this thing won't kick on at any point until I flip the lever on. And I did throw an extra capacitor on there. As you can see, I crafted one. So yeah, good stuff. So let's look at stuff. Ebony has more potency and less efficiency than ivory. I mean, they're both better than what I've currently got, which is, am I even using the Cymetal CAD? Which CAD am I using? I don't even know which one that is. I guess it's, this one? Yeah. All right. I guess I'm using the Cymetal CAD assembly. But yes, that's the gist, right? So, what we're looking at is efficiency is a reduction in psi energy use, and potency is how strong your psi spell can be. So I'm gonna go with an ebony one. So that's just 4 ebony psi metal ingots, which aren't terrible. It's just around a psi metal ingot. So I might have one of those in there. And done deal. Cool. So that's one. I'm gonna need 3 more of those. I don't know what I was thinking there. So that's that dude. Cool. So that's step one. The next one I want to take a look at is these guys. So hyperclocked CAD core and radiative CAD core, I guess. Complexity 32, projection 6. So complexity is this guy, the amount of actions. And projection is the number of tricks, right? So I'm gonna go with hyperclocked CAD core. So that is 2 ingots and 2 diamonds. Probably gonna want more ingots and diamonds here. So let's get, so there's greater infuse. Probably got regular infuse laying around here somewhere, but let's first get gold. Mm-hmm. Greater Infuse. I have to remember now. So I think I'll just have one spell that does this, and boom. There we go. And then I can change this to be Greater Infuse. And that's the one that works on the diamonds, right? Nice. Okay, cool. Now we're just gonna need, I'm gonna grab some redstone and glowstone. Because I'm pretty sure while I'm at it, I'm gonna need those. So this is the one I want with more complexity. Cool. Perfect. All right, next thing we're gonna want is bandwidth 9, sockets 10, bandwidth 8, sockets 12. So these guys are actually have already been craftable as well. So bandwidth is basically this thing in terms of how wide or high the spells can be, right? So I think if I want to make the most complex spells available, we're going to want more bandwidth. Sockets really just determines how many slots this thing has. So I've already got this, so I'm just going to go with the same, right? Bandwidth 9, sockets 10. Cool. And then the last component of this is a CAD battery. Might not be a terrible idea. So we're just going to need some iron and gold. This will make it so that if I cast a spell, it won't kill me, which I've had happened maybe once or twice. It should store extra energy inside a little battery. So let's see, CAD battery. The ultra dense one will be the best one, I guess. So that's cool. If I wanted to, I could color it. But I think I'm gonna hold off on that. There's more spell types too. Man, I have to get with Vasky and figure out some of the stuff. I do want to check out exosuits too, because exosuits are really cool. I want to show you guys what those are all about. So let's first put this away, make the new CAD gun. I think that's a wise decision. So first I'm gonna, why don't I organize my inventory real quick? I don't need all this stuff on me. So these can go away. The teleporter I don't need, these guys. I don't need my hammer at the moment. I'm not mining really much anymore. And the Eyes of Ender I don't really need, cool. So I'm gonna pull out all the bullets and we're gonna put this side gun away and we're gonna make a new one using all these materials. Cool. So this should be a really nice gun. Nice. Beautiful. Look at that. Okay. I guess one thing I wanna do is remove the ebony ivory thing. Just to make things a little bit easier. Nice. So one example of a spell is regen, right? So we've done regen before. I think if I get the regen bullet and a drive, let's see, which one probably don't I need? Place line, conjure block, closed door and open door. I'll do conjure block. I think if I craft these together, is this how it works? Thought there was a way to get from this drive into here. It might need to be empty. Yes, cool. So I just made a spell drive for regen, right? So I'm gonna put regen back in my gun. Cool. So before, that was the limit in potency, right? I couldn't do much better. But now I can have the power be 4? No, definitely not. 3 for 3 seconds, for 2 seconds, not bad. Regen 4 for 1 second, I wanna try it. So what if I had a lot of problems with my health? Doesn't regen all that much. I think I got about a heart and a half out of that, right? So let's do 3 for 3 for 2 seconds. What do I have? There we go. Yeah, definitely can only go for 2 seconds. If I want to do regen 3. This might also be more useful with Blink as well. Not bad. I think what I'll do is stick with regen 2, but only at 8 seconds now. So that's probably better. Cool. Let's get our Blink spell as well. Because Blink I'm always just a little bit short on. So let's make Blink. Right, we're going to put our Blink spell here. So let's bump this guy up to 10. Or 11. Yeah, 11 sounds like a good number. Yeah, that's definitely cool. So let's see if I'm down on the ground floor here, if I blink up. It's actually a little bit too high. I might want to bring it down. I'll make it 10. That sounds cool. Nice. All right, what do you say we check out some new Psy stuff? So one of the new features that we have available to us is actually really cool. We can get some armor from the Psy mod, and that's what we're gonna play with right now. So I'm gonna put this on. So in order for this to work, basically we put the armor in here. You'll notice that there are a few slots available. I'm gonna put in for now the regen ability. So that's pretty cool. And you'll notice that you even get a nifty little slot down here to swap in and out from. Makes things a little bit easier for you. The way the armor works is each of the different armor pieces has a condition which causes the spell to be cast. So the boots cast whenever you jump. The leggings will cast, I think, on tick. So maybe that's every tick, something like that. But if we take a look at C here, and we did exosuit casting, learn. We would get some more details, right? So just like with casting with tools, you can cast with armor. Now what's neat is the chest plate here will cast on event damage, and the Psy Metal Helmet has a specific event handler that we can craft, which we'll be taking a look at. But one thing we're definitely going to get our hands on is this dude, the exosuit controller. So Psy Metal ingot and redstone and a piece of glass. Nice. Just one. Cool. This is what allows you to control. You hit C to bring it up, and you'll notice that right now we've only got the armor on, right? So I'm going to activate regen. So now basically what should happen is as soon as I take damage, I should auto cast regen. You ready? Nice. Look at that. That is cool. Now I might want the auto cast one because that drained a lot of Psy energy. I might want to bring that down to 4 seconds. So that's only got a cost of about 840 as opposed to, yeah, definitely a lot. So 4 feels like a good number here. So what I'll do is take regen out of there. And this is a different spell bullet, by the way, than what I had originally. So we can equip our armor. Regen. Now we should get 8 seconds of regen whenever we take damage. Does that sound cool? So I think that includes environmental, but let's see. Nice. See how it's lasting for just a few seconds there? That is cool, right? Environmental damage included? Yeah, it does. Haha, awesome. The other nice thing is because I installed a battery in this thing, if I overcast, I will take some damage. That probably would have killed me had I not had the battery. But see how it's got that number 400 at the bottom? That's your internal battery's amount. I might have had a battery on the last one. I kind of forget if I did or not. But that's cool. Let's get the helmet, though, because the helmet has some really neat stuff in it. So we're going to remove this dude. We're going to get the Psy Metal Helmet, which just requires a couple more Psy Gems. I'm not sure. Let's see. Which infusion do I have active at the moment? I probably left it in my chest. Smite, move block, regen. Yeah, that'll do. So we'll do greater infuse. Let's get a couple more gems. Nice. We're gonna get the helmet. Excellent. Now, to get the thing that we need in here, there's a couple of things we can do. We can use the light sensor, the water sensor, the heat sensor, or the stress sensor. So I believe that these sensors are explained here. So that's, there you go, player taking damage, sensor based, read on, leggings, every tick, it'll cast the spell. Neat. So the water and light ones are pretty obvious. Let's see if it outlines the others here. So the stress sensor is low HP. That might be a better one to put regen on, but eh. But, you know, the light sensor is low light. So I want to show you the light sensor because this is really cool. Let's get a couple iron. And we'll make a light sensor here. Cool. I think all I have to do is craft these together and boom. Now, if I want to take it out, by the way, I think I just do that and we'll get our light sensor back. Neat. So you can swap these out as you wish. So to finish up this thing, we have to do the spell things that we get this round, right? So let's talk about that. So there's a couple ones that are available to us. We've got selector time, selects the CAD's internal time and ticks. So I think that's the world time. So let's see. Yeah. Oh yeah, differently depending on the time. That's cool. Dude, it's so cool seeing me cast regen every time I take damage. I love it. The other selectors here are... selector attacker and selector damage taken. They're used with the chest plate. The first selects the entity that attacked you. So if you wanted to smite whatever entity attacks you, you would have a smite spell with the target of selector attacker. We might want to give that a try. In fact, I kind of do. So let's do that. Let's make a new spell bullet. Okay, and we're going to do smite entity position attacker. Cool. So the position will be the position of whatever entity is attacking us. Okay, and I'm going to put that into my armor as well. And remember, I can use the exosuit controller to choose which I want. Now that I named stupidly Greater Infusion because I am a derp, we will call this, in fact, Smite. All right, de-derping it up. So in fact, let's make it nighttime again, just so we can test this out. It tried to smite the lightning. That's awesome. Cool. So we should now, if I choose this, we're gonna put on smite. Hey you, attack me. Hey skeleton, maybe you might wanna see me or something. All right, that didn't work so well. Apparently it makes you invisible too. Hey, skeleton. There's a me right here. Every time he hits me, he gets struck by lightning. How cool is that? I love it. Hey, zombie, how's it going? Oh, that's so cool. I know, I'm easily amused. Regen, please. All right, let's make it daytime. Seriously, though, right? I mean, anything that attacks me gets hit by lightning, I'll take it. All right. I'm done. Let's level up. So in order to level up, we're going to want to use the selector time. So let's just make a debug spell for this. So boom and boom. We'll make a quick. We will debug selector time. Cool. Nice and easy way to see what this does. So debug, boom. 16, 9, 16, 16, 9, 50, right? So it's a way to increment numbers like automatically. It's probably useful for some things that are beyond my level of skill. Neat. So now that we've got that, let's I know I did block conjuration, so I'm guessing some kind of update occurred that rolled back what I had. But we already checked out the trick conjure light. Let's use trick conjure block. So let's level up, right? So we're going to conjure block, and we're going to need to give it a position, which will be my position. You know, let's do this. Let's do some of entity position of the caster plus the entity look vector, which remember is always like one, right, of the caster. So I should have just replaced debug. So that should, given that there's a block to my right. Oh, right. It doesn't need to use the block to my right. That's cool. Hooray! So that's the conjure block trick. It's pretty neat. They are solid blocks and they're magical, which is always quite welcome. You kind of gotta, I mean, obviously you would want to put more time into where you're casting, right? I just did this as a quick to level up thing. Neat though, right? It actually uses connected textures. I don't know if you were noticing that. And if you give it a time number, so for example, if I put, let's say, it should be in ticks, right? Time number. So if we did 5, it should last for 5 ticks, which is about a quarter of a second, right? So if we did 40 ticks, that should last for about 2 seconds. Neat, right? So that leveled me up, but what I actually want to do is do conjure light, right? And the position is going to be entity position of the caster. Done deal, right? So let's change conjure block to conjure light. So if I cast this, it should cast a light directly at my position. So here's what's cool. If we have a helmet on with a light sensor in it, like that, and instead of having the conjure light spell in my gun, we put it in the helmet, it will automatically cast whenever the light level gets low. That's when it casts. So the conjure, or the low light event is what triggers the spell. So basically, whenever it's dark, it's gonna cast the create light spell. You ready? Let's go try it out downstairs. So first off, let's make sure, I think it's left and right click to toggle between your suit parts. We're gonna make sure conjure light is here, and I wanna have regen on this guy, right? Cool. So that means that, sweet. So anytime it gets dark, it should auto cast. Cool. Selected spell is conjure light. So let's get our break square spell ready here. We'll go down into our mining caves where it might get dark after a bit. I have to get to a point where it's not so well lit. Let's also bring up F4 here, because that might be a neat way to, so there's some, oh look, it already cast the spell. Nice. How cool is that? You ready? So pretty much as soon as we hit light level 7, how cool is that? And I'm just mining the diamond ore here because I found dense diamond ore. Neat tricks, right? Neat tricks. Wow, this is a great diamond vine. I just got like 32 diamonds off that. Awesome. Ta-da! Automatic light. So that triggers, by the way, when you go from light to dark. So that is pretty much awesome, right? Now, if you wanted it to be to the right of you or something like that, like obviously we know how that works and how to do that kind of trickery. That is cool. It might be light level 6 that it's triggering off of, because I'm seeing a couple of light level 7s that aren't causing it to trigger. But I imagine if I went in here, boom, it did, right? So it's probably less than 7 is probably what it's keying off of. How great is that, huh? Automatic lighting. Look at it. Boom, I step into a dark spot and it's lit. Boom, I step into a dark spot and it's lit. I know. I'm easily amused. Let's go home. I think there's a hotkey. Shift right click disables all spell abilities. And I think you have to reactivate them manually. I might be wrong about that. Low light and damaged. Yes, so shift right click is a hotkey to automatically deactivate everything that's currently active. Neat stuff. All right. I'm putting away all the stuff I just mined. Back in a sec. All right, so I think that's a good wrapping up point. I don't know if there's anything in particular I want to put on my boots or my legs. I'm going to take a look around and see what might be cool to put in there. We'll come back next episode. We may or may not start looking at, smeltery. What's that do? Trick smelt item. Smelt an item entity into its smelted counterpart. Nice. Selector nearby smeltables. That's cool. Trick smelt block. Smelt a block into its smelted counterpart. That's neat. I might want to try that out. Detection and focus, memory management. So that's pretty interesting. I've not played with these much yet. I remember Vasky telling me about how they work. Like, you know, the one that places blocks and the block has to be to the right of the casting assisting device, right? That's what detection and focus is. Selector, switch focus slot. Changes the focus slot of this spell and you can tell it which slot to focus on. So you can basically not have to have the block that you're using to the right of the CAD. Neat. But for now, I'm going to wrap up the episode. So, Direwolf20 signing off. Hope you guys enjoyed checking out some of the new stuff in Psy. I will probably be working on a spotlight update at some point for this mod because, you know, I definitely dig Psy because it's a little bit programming, a little bit magic, a little bit cool, a little bit OP. Lots of different things that can be used to describe Psy, and I like all of them. All right, guys, take it easy.